to a very special Late Late Show right here from the heart of London. Everybody, what an incredible thing for us to do. This is amazing for us. Right now, we are airing on CBS, as we always do every night, and this is exciting. Right now, we are also airing on prime time in Sky One, on Sky One right here in the United Kingdom. It's an amazing thing for us. We are here. We're here in the beautiful, historic Central Hall, Westminster. This is so amazing to be in here. I was reading about the history of this building last night. Did you know this? Gandhi spoke here in this building. Martin Luther King gave a speech here. Winston Churchill spoke here in this very hall. And despite all of that, they've still allowed me to come here and make a television show. Now, this is actually, it's actually a Methodist church. So the show's going to feel a little different to regular viewers. You probably won't spot the differences that much. But if everyone could please just turn to page 103 in your hymn books, we're going to kick off with Bread of Heaven. It's so nice to be here in England, to be at home. It really is. After 2.5 years of presidential campaigning in America, I was like, where can I go for another bitter, soul-sucking election? I know. London. But it's true. There's a big election coming up this week in the United Kingdom, and actually, this is true. This venue is going to be used as a polling station. So raise your hand if you didn't know there was a TV show here. You just came here early to try and beat the lines. If you're a first-time voter, you'd be pretty impressed with this experience. But why don't people vote more? I don't get it. I went, I loved it. There was a band playing. Nicole Kidman was there. she is. Now, we talk about Donald Trump almost every night on this show, but I thought, you know, when I came here to London, I thought I'd finally get away from him for a little while. And then I get here, and who does he start a fight with? The mayor of London. While I'm here in this city, honestly, he's following me. So, I'm not joking, he's totally obsessed with me, you guys. I think it's because I'm blonde with big boobs. he's in love with me, Jeremy. But back to the story. In a televised statement, Mayor Sadiq Khan said that if Londoners were to see more police out on the streets, that there was, quote, no reason to be alarmed. And what Donald Trump did was he took the no reason to be alarmed part and ignored the rest and tweeted it, implying that Mayor Khan is taking security too lightly. And this is what Trump does, right? I mean, and plays a lot of golf. But this is what Trump does. He takes a small part of what someone says and just ignores the rest. And we were looking at this since we got here and we thought, well, two can play that game, Mr. President. So this is one of your long, rambling tweets about fake news, right? And then we thought, well, what if we just took one small part, ignored the rest, and gave everyone the tweet they wish you'd write? And we did that right here. Apology accepted, Mr. President. I'm joking. Please let me re-enter America. Hello from London. We've been having all kinds of fun here this week, including Crosswalk, the musical's rendition of Mary Poppins, Carpool Karaoke with Ed Sheeran. You can catch it all right here and subscribe just there.